Hello friends, my name is Sankalp and today I am going to show you how I created my dashboard for Makeover Monday week 36. If you are new to this channel then please subscribe the channel for more of such interesting content. So let's start with today's tutorial. So first I will show you how I created my background in Figma app. So we'll just wait till it loads. Okay, so this was the dashboard I created. It's nothing but the texts and lines. So just have a look at Figma introduction video. I have given it in the I. Just click there and watch that video and then you'll understand creating the background like this is very easy in Figma. So just select desktop and export it. Now we will create our dashboard. So first go to Tableau, connect to dataset, go to text file and select your data. So this was the data for Makeover Monday week 36. Now drag grams of sugar to rows and grams of complex carbohydrates to columns. Just reverse these fields, then drag manufacturer to mark section. First drag manufacturer to filters, select all, apply, OK. Then drag name to the details section. Your points are now plotted. Go to show filter, select single value. And now you can see the values in our scatter plot. Go to edit axis. Change the title to sugar in grams. Fix this axis to -1 and 17 so that our points will be properly visible. Now go to the second axis. Again click on fixed. Here you have to write 0 and the second end is on 24. Give title as complex carbs in grams. Okay. You can see the values are changing. Select the marks as circle. Okay, now you have to go to edit axis and unselect the logarithmic. Okay, now our chart is proper. Now we have to select the points which are less than 4 grams of sugar and more than 15 grams of carbohydrates. So we'll just create their set and name it good cereals. Click on OK. Now drag this set to the color, give in color orange, click on apply and OK. Go to color, decrease its opacity and give the border. Increase the size of circles. And you can see our points are now exactly plotted. Go to format. Just do some formatting like remove grid lines, zero lines, axis rulers, axis ticks, etc, etc. Okay, now your scatter plot is ready. Set the view to entire view. Okay, we will just check whether all points are correct. Yes, it's all right. Now we will just rename this shade as scatter plot. Now we will move to the most important part of this tutorial, that is how to create those buttons. So first we will create three layers. First is background layer. Second is our main layer. And third is transparent layer. First, we'll create background layer. So for that, go to Figma. I've just created this. Export this rectangle. And then I gave color orange to this rectangle. And then again exported it. And move both of these files to the documents, my Tableau repository, shapes, Makeover Monday week 36. Here I save both of those rectangles. Now go back to Tableau. Drag manufacturer to the rows. Select marks as shape. Set view to entire view. Hide field labels from rows. Remove the show header. Then in shapes, first reload shape. Then go to Makeover Monday week 36 and select the white one. Increase the size of this shape. Control select the manufacturer and drag it to label. In label, in alignment, go to horizontal, select the middle one, and in vertical, select the middle one. Now just do some formatting to the text. Go to format, in format shading, for sheet select none, and in format lines, in format borders, go to row divider and set pen to none. Your background layer is ready. Just go to analysis, go to Tableau layout and show empty rows. This is very important step, guys. You have to do this for all of the layers, otherwise your view won't be proper. Now go to main layer and we have to do the same things as that of background layer. So first drag manufacturer, set marks to shape. In shape, you have to select the orange shape, click on apply, then OK. Set view to entire view. Hide field labels from rows. Remove show header. Increase its size. Control drag manufacturer to the label. Format this label. Set its alignment to the middle. Give it white color and Tableau bold font. Increase its size little bit. Go to format, go to format shading, select worksheet to none. In row banding, select pen to none. In format borders, select row divider to none. Okay, now you are done with main layer. Now we'll create transparent layer. So for that you will need to go to PowerPoint. Go to insert. Click on shapes. Click on square. Just draw a random square or rectangle. In shape field, select no fill. In shape outline, select no outline. And you have to save this figure. It's quite tricky. Okay, go select your figure, go to format, in shape outline, select no outline, and click here and click on save as picture. Now save this picture in the My Tableau repository, shapes, Makeover Monday week 36. Okay, now you are ready to create transparent layer. Do the similar process, that is, drag manufacturer to the rows, control drag manufacturer to the label, select marks as shape, set view to entire view, in shape, select the one you created in PowerPoint, apply OK. Just do some editing, remove everything from the view. Click on hide field labels from rows. Remove header. Go to format. Format shading in worksheet, select none. In format borders, in row divider, select none. Go to analysis of main layer, table layout, select show empty rows. In transparent layer, go to analysis, table layout, show empty rows. And now you are all set to create the dashboard. So first we will drag the image of our background layout. Click on fit image, in choose image. Click on the background that you have created. Now adjust the size of the layout. So the size of our layout was, we'll just see it in the Figma. It was 1100 by 650. So we'll just copy these values in the Tableau dashboard. So just go here, fix size, for width select 1100 and for height select 650. Now we'll remove the padding. So click on your image, select outer padding as 0. Now click on the dashboard, select outer padding as 0. Now we'll start dragging our sheets into the dashboard. So first we'll drag background sheet. Click on floating and drag the background sheet below, select the brand, hide its title, increase its size. Now drag main layer, hide its title and adjust it over the background layer. So it takes little time to adjust these things, so you can skip the video for next like 5 to 10 seconds. Let me adjust this. Just decrease the size. I'll go to main layer and increase the size of this shape, and perfect. Now we are all set. So the last step is to drag transparent layer on this both layers. So remove its header title and adjust this layer on this background. Okay, now you are almost ready. Just increase the size of this transparent layer. Okay, now we'll give life to these layers. So go to actions, in add actions, select filter, in source sheet, select transparent sheet, transparent layer, run action on select, clearing the selection will leave the filter, and in target sheets, select only main layer. Click on OK. OK. Now you can see we have created a filter using these buttons. Now we will drag our main plot in the visualization. Remove its title, adjust its size. click on the brands and you will see our view is getting adjusted automatically. Just adjust everything according to our needs. Now again go to Figma. I have created this rectangle so that all the points in orange color will appear in this box. So just export this rectangle, drag image as a floating to the our view, click on choose and select our rectangle. Apply, OK. Now adjust this rectangle according to our graph. So greater than 15 and less than 4. Check whether all the points comes into this rectangle or not. They all are in the rectangle, so it's fine. Now we'll again go to the image and drag that arrow. Apply, OK. Adjust the size of this arrow and drag it in the view according to its position. Okay, great. And congratulations, your dashboard is ready. Just click on the brands and you will get your view sorted. This was the main dashboard that I have created. So this was the dashboard I submitted in the Makeover Monday challenge. This is the formatted version in which you can see I have added some animations also. So now I will show you how I added those animations. So for that, go to format, click on animation, click on, set duration to 0.5 seconds, and now you can see automatically the points are like animations. So that's it from my end, guys. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe the channel for more of such awesome content. Thank you.